In this video, we're going to show you how to use the ValueLOG. The ValueLOG is the next generation, low-cost, high-performance data logging device for CAN FD and LIN networks. The ValueLOG includes Ethernet, CAN FD, single-wire CAN, and LIN all in one tool. All channels run simultaneously and are timestamped within the hardware. The ValueLOG comes with four dual-wire CAN or CAN FD channels, one channel of single-wire, one channel of LIN, one Ethernet for 100 base TX for DoIP, and 32 gigabytes of internal flash memory to store all your data and more. In addition, on the top of the case, you will see an OBD2 male connector to easily plug into your car's OBD2 port. The ValueLOG supports various adapter cables, each serving its own unique purpose. One such cable is the OBD2 to 4 DB9 adapter cable. By connecting banana jacks to a power source, you can run the ValueLOG device. Other useful cables are the OBD2 to J1939 and the OBD2 to DB26 adapter cables. These connections open up compatibility with a wide range of systems and expands the applications of the ValueLOG tool. On the front of the device, you will see four programmable tri-color LEDs to show link, error, and activity status, as well as a USB Type-C connector to configure and extract your data. On the side, you will find the external antenna input. And lastly, on the back side of the case, you will find the ValueLOG pinout. To configure your data, connect the ValueLOG device to your computer using the USB Type-C cable while also running Intrepid's Vehicle Spy software. Once your ValueLOG is connected to Vehicle Spy, go to the NeoVi Explorer to configure the hardware settings. One of the easiest ways to do this is by clicking the Setup Hardware button located in the main Vehicle Spy toolbar, or by clicking on the Setup menu and then selecting Hardware. In NeoVi Explorer, you will be able to update your NeoVi firmware, change CAN network settings, LIN network settings, and much more. Next, we'll show you how to set up your device for standalone data logging. Once in Vehicle Spy, go to Vehicle Scape DAC located in the Measurement menu, or click on the Vehicle Scape DAC button that can be found on the login screen. You can access Vehicle Scape features via the main Vehicle Spy window tab. The tabs are generally used in order from left to right. A typical workflow begins with loading databases, selecting which channels to log, and then generating a script for the hardware to run by itself. You can also add multiple configurations by using the plus button near the top right corner of the window and select different configurations using the drop-down list. Click on the standalone logging tab, then select message capture. You can log all bus messages that are coming in through the hardware, or you can log only the items selected on the channels tab. You will have an option to either start immediately, start when the expression is true, or you can choose to start when a certain expression is true. For example, if the signal is greater than 5, then it will start logging immediately. Built into Vehicle Scape DAC is another exciting feature that allows you to create different trigger options. For example, you can start a trigger when the expression is true for at least 10 seconds. You can also trigger when the expression changes or when the trigger expression is increased or decreased. You can also configure the logger to stop after a certain time or a certain message. You can collect vehicle bus data before and after the trigger event by selecting pre/post collection. There is also a feature that allows you to have a one-shot report. For example, if the expression is true, we can log for 5 seconds. In addition, you can also stop the trigger at any condition or can set pre and post triggers based on time or number of messages. To create standalone logging scripts, click on the Generate button, check Run After Download, and click Send. Next, we will learn how vehicle data can be extracted from the ValueLOG hardware using a USB. Once you have your hardware connected to Vehicle Spy, go to Tools and select Extract/Export. This view is divided into two major areas, Extract tab and Export tab. Extract tab reads Vehicle Spy archive files from the device and converts them into Vehicle Spy binary files on the PC. In the Extract tab, you will see the source location appear at the top. If you have the ValueLOG device plugged in via USB, then you will see your hardware name listed in this drop-down menu. Next is to tell our application where to put the data. This can be done using the Browse button found in the Output Directory section. You can use the time entries on the top to filter the data you need. In the Extract view, you can use the file tree to select the data you would like to see. The last step is to click on the Extract Selected Files button to see the parsing results area for a status report. You can also use the Select All button to select all files, as well as the Clear Section button to clear your section view. The Advanced Settings button will open the dialog that shows the settings on various tabs. Clicking the Load Defaults button will revert all of the extractor settings back to their original defaults. The General tab allows you to combine your extracted file into one VSB file or split into limited size VSB files using the settings here. Regional Settings tab lets you control how the date and time will appear. Advanced tabs are used for troubleshooting, and in most cases, they will not need to be changed. Export tab helps you configure how data is exported and converted. Once you have made your selection, select the Extract All Files button, and you will be able to see the parsing results area to view your status results. The Transfer File System button allows you to copy the VSB files from the card to the PC. In the Extract view, you also have buttons for Transfer File System, Extract User Files, and Clear Logged Data. The Extract tab allows you to read extracted VSB files and exports them into other various signal or message file formats. You can extract the VSB files from the hardware and verify the output directory is where the extracted VSB files are going to be saved. You can select the VSB file to export in the raw data file list on the left, and then select the signals to export on the right. On the bottom, you will have a drop-down menu to pick a signal or message file format. In this single drop-down menu, you will find CSV, MAT, and MDF formats. In the Message Data drop-down menu, you will find CSV, ASC, BLF, PCAP, and PCAP-NG. Click the Export button to make the new file and watch the status update directly below. In addition, you can also use your ValueLOG device with our open source API on our GitHub page. We work hard to provide you with the best hardware and software experience. Not only does all our hardware go through a 24-hour burn-in test to find any potential problems, but we also do regression testing on our Vehicle Spy software. To learn more about this device, please read our full documentation at intrepidcs.com/ValueLOG. If you have any questions, please contact our support team. Thanks for watching.